Archives of Prasar Bharati presents The Timeless Treasure of Golden Era.
The variety, complexity, and richness of contemporary Indian art is partly due to the breakdown of the school system of the past, and partly to the multiplicity of exposures to which contemporary urban artists remain open. These can also lead them to mere eclecticism. But the appropriation from pre-existing art forms has to be purposive in order to be authentic. Madhavi Parekh selects those elements from sources of her choice which she can transform and integrate into her paintings. It is difficult to pinpoint any particular folk tradition which has influenced her. However, surface resemblances of Madhavi's paintings to pre-existing art and her own biography indicate that the figuratively embroidered textiles of Gujarat have been one of her sources of inspiration.
Bye.
She has particularly been influenced by the so-called temple cloth. As her husband and fellow artist, Manu Parekh points out, Madhavi is too sophisticated and individualistic in her thematic and stylistic concerns to be regarded as a folk painter.
I was engaged to Madhavi at the age of 12 and she was 9. We got married at the I was 18, she was 15. But we started living together after 4-5 years. During her first pregnancy, she told me, maybe within 2-3 months, that she wanted to learn painting. I thought, because in India during the pregnancy, women try to learn, try to read some good things like Ramayana and Mahabharata to give a kind of a good sanskar to their child. I thought she was interested in thinking that kind of a thought. So within a week, I taught her Paul Klee's pedagogical exercises, which is to use square, circles, triangles. But within a 4-5 days, I saw a very interesting change, that she started doing almost many fantastic things, full of animals, birds, some strange kind of a creature, which she started doing so seriously that till the day my first daughter born, she was doing very regularly, even in Bombay, and then she went to her village, Sanjaya, and she continued that kind of a work.
Yet, Madhavi's handling of images and colors strongly remind us of Indian folk art in general. Manu Parekh is again right in pointing out that as a person born and brought up in rural Gujarat, with fond memories of childhood, Madhavi shares with the folk artist a rural sensibility. It is that sensibility which gives to the world of her paintings a seemingly folk ambience.
When she started working with a kind of a full of fantasy, I think she remained in the village for her childhood for almost 20 years, and her experiences in villages, a kind of a festivals and many things. There is a common similarity with folk art because she is also working from a rural sensibility. Her, I think, main important factor in her work is a contemporary painting, but done with a rural sensibility. And there, I think, there is some similarity with folk tradition, because she always go back to her childhood memories. She lived in Bombay, Delhi, Calcutta, but again, all the time for her work, she goes back to her childhood memories.
It is that kind of shared sensibility which has led to coincidental resemblances between the flying goddess of the Jhabua Bhil painter Bhuri Bai and Madhavi Parekh's flying Durga. The procession scenes in Madhavi's paintings, especially their chromatics, are reminiscent of the Pithora paintings of the Rathwas of Gujarat. But these must be regarded as unconscious. However, in order to objectify her personal experiences and memories, Madhavi constantly draws from two large and amorphous resource bases. She constantly goes back into embroidered textiles and its figurative images. One gets the feeling that beyond the Gujarat textiles, she also draws inspiration from the Bengal kathas. During her 10-year stay in Calcutta, she must have got to know about this traditional pictorial form of Bengali embroidery. Gathas are the only embroidered textiles in which we find elaborate narratives. Like in many of Madhavi's paintings, the figures in gathas are to be seen from varying angles and not from any fixed point.
তার কাছে সব পরাজয়। পাগল মন আমার পাগল মন পাগল মন পাগল পাগল গোলাম যদি রঙের হয় তার কাছে সব পরাজয় সে করে নাই আর কারু ভয় সে করে নাই আর কারু ভয় চলে যাবন জোরেতে এসেছ বসেছ ভাবে দাস লালন বলে কি করিলি হবে খেলতে বসে হেরে গেলি লালন বলে কি করিলি হবে খেলতে বসে হেরে গেলি চিরজীবন বাঁধা রইলি চিরজীবন বাঁধা রইলি ছক্কা পাঞ্জার হাতেতে এসেছ বসেছ ভবে দাস খেলিতে
Madhavi's second resource base is the general narrative tradition of folk painting, fine examples of which are the Vigyapti Patras of the Jains and the Pithora paintings of the Rathwas and the scroll pots of Bengal.
খেলতে বসে হেরে গেলি চিরজীবন বাঁধা রইলি চিরজীবন বাঁধা রইলি ছক্কা পাঞ্জার হাতেতে এসেছ বসেছ ভবে দাস খেলিতে এসেছ বসেছ ভবে দাস খেলিতে এসেছ বসেছ ভবে দাস খেলিতে এক ব্রহ্ম টেকার মর্ম তুমি জেনে নাও মোহনাকে
To recapitulate the unfolding of the narrative in scroll pots, we went back to Noya Gram in West Bengal and tried to locate a woman Potua so that we could project an urban-rural continuity and rediscover a woman's way of looking at things.
অশ্বপতি নামে রাজা অবন্তের পতি তার শত্রু নিল রাজ্যবনে করিল বসতি একদিন গেল সত্যবানে খেলিতে বাজারে
We found Rani Chitrakar visiting a village on her daily rounds
সত্যবানে দেখে সাবিত্রী ভাবে মনে মনে বলে ইহারে করিব স্বামী মনেতে ভাবিয়া হরষিতে গেলেন কন্যা গৃহেতে ফিরিয়া, পিতা মাতার নিকটেতে বলে প্রকাশিয়া, সত্যবানের সঙ্গে বাবা আমার দাহ বিবাহ। সে কথা শুনিয়া রাজা বলেন কন্যারে, দুঃখিত জনারে বিভা না দুব তোমারে। হেন কালে সেই দিন দেখো দৈবের ঘটন, রাজার সভাতে এলেন নারদ তপোধন। নারদ দেখিয়া রাজা পরম আদরে, বসিতে আসন রাজা দিল যত্ন করে। মুনি জিজ্ঞাসেন এই কন্যাটি কাহার, রাজা বলে এই কন্যা হয়েছে আমার। মুনি বলে ইহার বিবাহ দিয়েছ কোনখানে, রাজা বলে না জানি বলিল কোন জনে। সাবিত্রী বলেন গো প্রভু মুনি বিদ্ধবানে, ওই সত্যবান নামে রাজা অবন্তেরে পতি। বিয়ে হয়ে সত্যবান নয়ে যায় ঘরে, শ্বশুর শাশুড়ির সেবা সাবিত্রী যে করে। স্বামীর মরণ হবে গো সাবিত্রী তা জানে, বলে কেমন নয়ে যাবে জম দেখিব নয়নে। হেন কালে দেখো তো বিধাতার লিখন, দেখো কে করে খণ্ডন, আজ সত্যবান বনে গেল কাষ্টের কারণে।